Hello everyone, we're back with our series of shortcut tips and tricks. In today's video, we'll study a shortcut trick from the chapter of ratio, proportion and variation. So let's start it. Suppose you're given a question like this: what common number must be subtracted from 11, 27, 34 and 96 so that they are in proportion, right? So basically they're saying that these numbers 11, 27, 34 and 96 are not in proportion right now. But if you subtract a common number from each of them, they'll be in proportion. So we can say that basically 11 minus x upon 27 minus x is equal to 34 minus x upon 96 minus x. So now there are two basic methods to do this question. First is you apply component or dividend or simplify this and solve this, but that takes a bit of time. The second method is that you put in options. Put 1 first, then 2 first, then 3 first, 4 first. See which satisfies it and you will get an answer. And then there's another method. Suppose you're given 4 numbers which must be in proportion. And these numbers are A, B, C and D. Right? So the number that must be subtracted, let's say it is X. So X can be written as A into D minus B into C upon A plus D minus B plus C, right? Basically, just take the pairs, like extremes is one pair and means are one pair, right? So first multiply them and take a difference and then add them and take a difference. Let's do it with this question. So in this question, it will be 11 into 96 minus 27 into 34 upon 11 plus 96 minus 27 plus 34, right? So let's calculate this. 11 into 96 comes out to be 6 here and another 6 over here. So this comes out to be 1056 minus 27 into 34 can be written as 8 and 10 gets carried over. 27.3 is 81.8 and this comes out to be 918. Okay, 11 plus 96 is 107 minus 27 plus 34 is 61. So this is what we need to calculate out. So 1056 minus 918 can be written as 138. Yeah, and 107 minus 61 can be written as, this comes out as 6, and 10 minus 6 is 4, this comes out as 46. And 138 by 46 gives us 3. So the correct answer would be option C. So with this, you can directly solve these type of questions. Because for example, there could be questions where you're not given options like this, where you're given that the common number satisfies an equation and they'd give you an equation like x square plus something, something, something. And then you don't have all these options to actually check. So in that case, you must know a method where you actually get the answer instead of relying on options. So in that case, this technique comes in handy a lot. Suppose the question is given, what common number must be added? Right? And some other set of numbers is given. Then also, you'll use the same approach, but instead, you'll get a negative answer. For example, if the question is what common number must be added to 7, 16, 17 and 36 so that they are in proportion, we'll do the same thing. X is equal to AD minus BC upon A plus D minus B plus C, right? So now AD is 7 into 36 minus 16 into 17 upon 7 plus 36 minus 16 plus 17, right? Okay, 7 into 36 gives us 2 here, 4 on the other side. So this gives us 252. And 16 into 17 gives us 272, right? 36 plus 7 gives us 43. And 16 plus 17 gives us 33. So basically what we get is minus 20 upon 10, which is nothing but minus 2. So since the question is asking what must be added, you'll ignore the negative value and take the number as its positive value. So the correct answer would be option B. And you can see 7 plus 2 is 9, 16 plus 2 is 18, right? 17 plus 2 is 19, 36 plus 2 is 38. So 9 2za gives us 18, 19 2za gives us 38. So they are now in proportion. So this is the formula that you need to remember, that the product of extremes minus product of means upon sum of extremes minus sum of means. And with this, you'll be able to solve any question of this type. That's it for this video. We'll soon be back with a new video about a shortcut tip or trick. Thank you.